Who?
I gotta get up, gonna get the rental car. I'm gonna get on the road by noon. Yeah, confident paying for that shit.
What color you got on, Goose? White?
White, probably.
I'm on four plays, that's it. Yeah, cause you was part of Wojo team, you was running all that crazy shit.
Mm-hmm. Saying, bitch, you can't get the 50 yard.
Damn.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome.
What you gonna say?
It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line.
I concur.
Man, Finn ain't played in probably 2 months.
Who cares? You ready?
Yes, sir. Between Nas and Jay-Z.
Well, what would I be without my baby? We know you,
man, dude. So my fucking Apple Watch broke the other week, right? So I sent that bitch to get repaired, right? So they sent the bitch back. They sent me a different one. I had a Series 2. They sent me a Series 3. This bitch won't even patch him with goddamn phone. So I get back on the chat with Apple. They set me up for Geek Squad at Best Buy today. These bitches trying everything, man. They bitches wipe my phone back to fucking factory reset. But I backed it up before I left. So now when I get to New Jersey, they got me scheduled to go to an Apple store. And they said if they can't fix it, they should give me a new one right there. And there we see an early burst that makes him want to leave. But I'm not letting my fucker wipe my phone in there. Because I ain't taking my laptop with me. Vision for him.
It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. It is, it's just,
I think what they sent me is, they sent me a refurbished watch that probably had connection issues already. And the bitch still ain't fixed. One that they sent me, they thought it was fixed and it ain't fixed.
Apple do all that?
That's what
refurbished watch is?
They see you. Yeah, they see you. I don't see you no, I ain't paid the $270. For the fix, I know they ain't sending me no brand new goddamn watch for $220. Falls incomplete. It'll be second
down. Watch him sell a refurbished.
I mean, but it, like I said, he ain't had no blemishes or nothing on it. I'm sure one brand new. Because he just did it on that one, forced the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it? Absolutely, freeze up your guys elsewhere. And nearly an I don't like how they let you do that shit. But instead, third down. Fuck that nigga just come across the goddamn man. Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him. Especially on those deep passes. Oh, he was really turning around. Fuck the ball, bro. Stop playing with the real man. We're not playing 3 yards in the cloud of dust football anymore. You know where I'm from. I gotta get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football.
Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
I think they got to go have a plan in phone. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan.
He completes it to Julio Jones. Dan Quinn's guys unable to come through there on fourth down. And this crowd into it early. Their guys stand tall on the opening drive of the football game. On first and 10, here's Breeze.
Again has it complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Working.
A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
With the NG running.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. Watching. They do go for it. It's Breeze.
Going
and that's
right.
Complete. It's Watson. He's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Defensively, a bit of a collapse, allowing the fourth down play to result in 23 yards.
Go all the way over there.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Breeze now on first down. He dumps it down to Ingram. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pick up on first down. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
He goes underneath to Ingram. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five and the six.
He's going to call a timeout, buddy.
And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. From the gun, it's Breeze. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Grady Jarrett getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of four. Breeze to throw on second down. And he's got him. He's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Benjamin Watson, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Lutz now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down.
I see 21
at about the 23-yard line. Ryan to the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 23.
A little run for you.
Now Ryan.
Oh, Jesus.
Receiver complete. Julio Jones all alone.
And
he'll be down deep into New Orleans territory. A big play there, Ryan to Jones. 65 yards.
That was a nice pickup. Some chunk yardage there. Some of those big yards downfield with a little bit of rack thrown in there. A little run after catch. And it came on a crossing route. I can just hear one of my friends who won four Super Bowls as a quarterback always said the same thing. What route does a defense hate? Crossing route. Hate it, hate it, hate it, because it's hard to change direction when they get going full speed in the other way.
Get up!
Pick. When they start putting stars on them motherfuckers? Let me be the captain.
Now Ryan on second down. Caught by Jones.
Yeah, it don't matter.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. How about the first quarter? He's putting together out wide. Pretty impressive.
I think that he likes his back when he's playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings, so for some reason it builds up.
And it'll be pulled in by the tight end. It's Hooper for the Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper from 6 yards away. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game.
I think shot changed that name to this.
Point up and good. And we are tied at 7.
That was him and Miles were doing at the same time. Miles changed out.
So right back where we started. All even as the
you changed
away.
Out back. Yeah. I'm like D1.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line.
Miles.
Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense.
Man, I should have picked that block up.
In the passing game.
Damn, I can miss that block.
Pass rush. Pass rush.
Those guys up. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, 69 yards. And the Saints are able to strike quickly for 6. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver.
So
I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Oh, you ain't getting that in on that either.
And just falls short down at the 1 yard line.
Learned that from Miles.
A big run there by Freeman. Give him 69 yards on the ground.
I learned this from Sellers.
Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation.
Stop playing, man.
Into a mass of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal. Another shot from the one on second and goal. And now whistles here and a flag down.
Looked like someone got going a little early.
Mm-hmm. You know, like ugly. Hey, man, I like ugly, bro. Watch your defense, Sully. It's the best defense in the game, Sully.
Things made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on second and goal. Ryan. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it in.
Oh, and that'll be hauled in by the tight end. It's Hooper for the Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper with his second touchdown here in this first half. Well, the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Bryant tacks on the extra point. And we've got a tie game here in a back and forth first half.
Let me tell you what to do. Me and my kettle one. Mm-hmm. My baby sleep. Mama covered.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away.
Shit, I'm ready. Ready?
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. But they have to be careful.
You don't know what to do, Kelly.
It's not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that
easy
here. I
don't like it to make that play again.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road,
watch out for that thing. Watch out for that thing.
You got
to
get the ball. Win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling if you keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Now, Sully, I'm going to click on and do it myself.
But it'll wind up incomplete.
Watch. Watch me, Sully.
Now Breeze on third down.
High. Let me get that. Oh.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance
like
to affect the pass.
Having a hard time.
Now, three straight incompletions. They don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth.
Got him.
They're indeed going for it as they look to
got
throw. Looking deep downfield. And that's caught inside.
See that way you were going, man. I knew it. I knew where he was going.
There. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward.
Got him again, Sully. Watch this shit, Sully. Got him again. Got him looking in the cookie jar.
Breeze. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And he bats it away. It falls down incomplete. He was trying to get it that time to Ted Ginn. And now it's second down.
Sully.
This secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back. But that's one step in the proper direction.
Why this shit end up?
Second and 10 now from the 27.
Take practice. End up like this shit. I do it like this.
Got it.
It's gonna fuck up the whole defense.
Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. He's gonna take a shot for the end zone.
That end up?
Touchdown, Saints.
There you go, right there.
27 yards. And the Saints have moved down in front. Lutz to try to add the PAT. Lutz good on the extra point. And the lead is now 21-14. Lutz now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep.
Just call me Dr. McGee. You're right, bitch.
And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And Charles, away touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing. It's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of the game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
This motherfucker, hey, man, this freaking just slapped me.
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Here's Ryan. And that's incomplete. Trying to get that in the hands of Devontae Freeman that time. And it'll bring up third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Now it's Ryan. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Sheldon Rankins in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a 4th down.
If you want
to
learn how to play, you better stay your ass up, man.
Well, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down.
Gun! Right!
They'll indeed go for it with Ryan.
And he's
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down.
That won't happen no more.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it
anyway.
I
thought I was throwing it to Julio. I had to run defense. He ain't holding that defense. Yeah, I ain't never seen someone like that.
So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. On first down, Ryan. And he will find Ridley on the left side. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Calvin Ridley, 29 yards. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Bryant's extra point up and good. And we got a tie game here in a back and forth first half. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone.
Oh, in my house, too.
And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. I'm not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Now a play fake here on first game. Down. He'll let it fly in the direction again. He couldn't ball pops out incomplete.
Bruh, you got that shit down good, though, bro. I don't know how the fuck you throw that shit away from me. But I be on that shit, and I still can't catch up.
I can let you catch up, too. I got a dog at the gear.
He's gonna rifle one deep left side.
Give me that little nigga. Shut up, little nigga. Shut up. Shut up, little nigga.
And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. A big play. Breeze finding Thomas. 64 yards.
Touchdown.
Throwing now is Breeze. Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Grady Jarrett in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Okay, we do it like that.
First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further.
Grady. Here we go. 21, 21, 21. Oh, wow. What are you doing, Deion?
Good coverage that time by the linebacker, Deion Jones.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers,
no,
you know that
right
in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, 21, 21, see 21. The ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Well, yeah. Oh.
He's now on third and goal. Looking for the end zone.
He tried to one hand it. You got to go with two hands.
Picked off by Robert Alford. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. Mm-hmm. They were already in field goal range. But boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board. But give credit to the guys on the defensive side.
I'm like, give me a minute.
Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
35 seconds, all that remains in the first half as they come up on first down.
Don't do what I think you're going to do, man. Okay? You're going to give the ball right back.
Here's Ryan. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Ryan now at 200 yards already in this first half, and he's not done yet. First and 10.
Right,
Ryan. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to move that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Line of scrimmage, the 31 as they line up second and 10.
Got him right where we want him. Sleep window.
Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. The left side completion to Jones. 20, 10, touchdown, Falcons.
Mm-mm.
Julio Jones, as the first half is winding down.